Bonjour, Genie Engineers! In this video, I will be talking about all the things that you must know before you start studying for your FE, or as some people call it, EIT exam. See, before I started studying for this test, I wish somebody has given me these tips because I would have studied much smarter and I would have managed my time much better. Now, I want to share with you guys all these tips and the habits that you can build as you're studying so that you can prepare yourself better for the day of the exam. Now, make sure you stick around to the end of this video because I will be talking about all the specifications that are on the NCEES website, which are really important for this exam. If you want to know why or when or which FE you should take, I would recommend that you check out my other video where I try to answer all those questions, and hopefully it can help you decide which and when you should take your FE. Now, before we start, don't forget to subscribe. Okay, so the first thing we will talk about is time during the exam. This is really important because, well, first of all, on the NCEES website, it's not really clear about the time. So, I mean, they tell you you have 5 hours and 20 minutes for 110 questions and you get about 25 minutes break. But when do you get that break? So, and they don't either tell you how much you're supposed to spend on the first session or how much you're supposed to spend on the second session. And here you're probably thinking, well, I didn't even know there were like 2 sessions. So I want to clarify all these things for you so there are no surprises during the test. You can also use this time management if you're planning on taking a practice exam at home, which I definitely recommend before you take the actual test. So as I mentioned earlier, if you visit the NCEES website, which I will leave the link below if you want to check it out, on there, they specify the time you have during this test. So you get about 5 hours and 20 minutes for 110 questions. So that comes down to about 2.9 minutes per question. However, I do not recommend that you spend 2.9 minutes for every question because some questions will require 30 seconds and some you will need probably about 5 minutes. So just keep this in mind. This test is not supposed to be hard, it's supposed to be straightforward, no tricks, it's just fundamentals of engineering, it's just a review of all the classes that you already took in college. So if a question takes you about 30 seconds during the test, that's probably all you need. So I've had questions where I only needed to spend 20 seconds and some questions required more. So don't doubt yourself and don't hesitate. Just put the answer down and just move on to the next one. Next, we're going to talk about when to flag a question. See, before I took my test, a lot of people recommended that I should go over all the questions at the beginning before I start solving. And then as I go through the questions, I'm supposed to like flag the questions that I don't know or I think I won't know how to solve. And I don't recommend that because you'll be spending about 10 minutes just going over the problems, not even solving them. And so where you could be spending those 10 minutes actually solving the problem. So here I'm going to share with you 3 tips or 3 cases on when to flag a question. Case number 1, if you see a question that covers a concept that you've never seen before, flag it right away because you will be spending time on something that you don't know how to approach and it's not worth your time. You want to spend time where you know the questions and you know how to solve them rather than spending time on one question that you're not sure and then you might, there's like 25% you might get it right. So just flag it right away, move on to the next one. Case number 2, there's a question, you've seen the concept before, you know it, you just forgot about it or you're just not sure, you're not clear. I would say attempt it. Give it a minute or 2 minutes, try it. If you're not sure, if you get stuck, stop right there, do an educated guess, write the answer down and flag it. Come back to it later. It is not worth your time to spend so much time in one question where you could actually be spending that time solving problems that you know and gain more points. So don't get stuck. Remember, time management is very important for these type of tests. Case number 3. You see the question, you know it, you know the steps, you know the equations you're supposed to use, but it's long. It's gonna take you a long time to solve it, like about 5 minutes, 6 minutes. What I would do in that case, I would flag it and I would move to the next one and come back to it later. So here's what I would also recommend. Try to leave some time at the end of your test so that you can go over those questions that you flagged. Now, when you do that, make sure you go to case three first. Solve case three because you know the questions already. You know exactly the question, the equations you need. You just need time to solve it, right? So at the end, when you're done, start with solving the questions that you flagged for case three. Once you're done with those questions, then you go back to case one. The reason I say case one, because remember, case one, you didn't put an educated guess, you didn't put an answer. So make sure you answer all questions. So go back to case one, but try to attempt it, whatever it is, solve it, and then go back to case two, where you put an educated guess, but you just want to double check your answer. Now we're going to talk about the two sessions that I mentioned earlier. So when you reach around 55 questions, it will ask you if you want to submit your answers. Now you have to make sure here that you have submitted, you have answered all the questions, because once you hit submit, you cannot go back and change your answers. Now, as I mentioned earlier, if you have flagged any questions, make sure you leave 10 to 15 minutes at the end so that you can go back and review those flagged questions and put an answer down. So for the first 55 questions, I would recommend that you spend no more than 2 hours to 2 hours and 20 minutes. And the reason why is because the first part is just the basics of engineering, like math, statics, statistics, ethics, engineering, econ, strength of materials. So don't spend more than 2 minutes per question, because you're going to need more time on the second part. If you do spend more than 2 minutes, you're probably overthinking it. Remember, this test is just a review for your engineering classes. Don't overthink it and keep it simple. So before we jump in into the second part of the exam, I would like to talk about the break. See, a lot of people would just skip this part, and I definitely don't recommend it. Our body is not designed to sit for a straight 6 hours with no food, no water, and just doing deep work. Your performance will drop in the middle of the test. And you don't have to take a full 25 minutes if you don't want to. You can just take 10 to 15 minutes break. So during that break, you can get some water, get some fresh air, get some food, have a snack that will boost your energy. Try to stay away from the sugar because you don't want to crash in the middle of the test. And remember, you don't have to rush through the test. Just enjoy the ride. Okay, so after the break, you will start on the second part of the test, which is about 55 questions. So hopefully by then you have like 3 hours left to solve these problems. So these questions mostly gonna cover whatever FE discipline you picked. So here's an example. Let's say you're taking FE Civil, right? So you will, those questions will mostly cover hydrology, hydraulics, steel, reinforced concrete, soil mechanics, and foundation. Whereas if you're taking FE Mechanical, you'll see more questions on thermodynamics, heat transfer, control systems, and so on. So some of the questions will require about 2 minutes to 6 minutes maximum. So if you're spending more than 6 minutes, you're probably overthinking it again. So make sure to try to keep it simple. And if you get stuck in a question, don't forget to use my 3 methods that I mentioned earlier on how to flag a question. Flag the question, come back to it later. You don't want to get stuck in one question when you can be solving so many other questions. So time is very valuable. Make sure you have a strategy on how to manage your time better. So the next thing I would like to talk about is calculator. So if you visit the NCEES website, they have their calculator policy here, and they tell you like the 3 types of calculators that are allowed during the exam, the FE exam. And so I personally prefer the TI-36X Pro. That's the one I actually got. I got it from Amazon for only like 20 bucks. I will leave the link below if you're interested and if you want to check it out. But the reason why I prefer the TI-36X Pro is because it is very similar to the calculator that I used in college, which is TI-89. And also it has really cool functions like standard deviation and matrices that saved me a lot of time during the exam. So specifications, I definitely recommend that you take a look at the specifications before you start studying for the exam. because it really tells you exactly what's going to be on the exam, and you can use that to build a strategy to study for your test. So let's visit the website together. So this is the NCEES website. Don't worry about the link. I will make sure to leave it in the description below. On here, they go over the time, which we already talked about, so you don't have to worry about it. They also tell you, you know, how to log in and like the fee for this test. And down here, we have exam specifications. So we have different types of FEs, as you can see. We have chemical, civil, electrical, and computer. We have environmental, industrial, and systems. We have mechanical, and we have FE other disciplines, which is also known as FE general. So for each of these FEs, we have specifications where, as I mentioned earlier, it's just a PDF file that tells you the materials that will be covered on the exam. Let's take a look at the FE Civil specifications as an example. I know some of you are probably not taking the FE Civil, but I still think you can use the same method. So this is the FE Civil specifications. And then here we have the subjects that will be covered on the exam. So we have mathematics, we have probability and statistics, we have computational tools, we have ethics, engineering, econ, statics, dynamics, mechanics of materials, fluid mechanics, hydraulics and hydrology, structural analysis, structural design. Structural design includes steel and reinforced concrete. Then we have geotechnical engineering, which includes soil mechanics and foundation. Then we have transportation engineering, environmental engineering, construction and surveying. So the first part, remember how I was talking about we have two parts in the test. We have the first part that covers the basics of engineering. So the first part really you will see problems more oriented towards math, probability, computational tools, ethics, engineering, econ, static, dynamics, mechanics of materials. And I did have a little bit of fluids, but I had more fluids on the second portion. And I definitely had construction covered on the first portion of my test. So the second part of my exam, I had a lot of questions on hydraulics, hydrology, structural analysis, structural design, geotechnical engineering, transportation, environmental, and surveying. So another thing I would recommend that you do is, as you guys notice here, we have number of questions. And so this is the breakdown. It gives you how many questions you might get on this subject on your test. So this, you should use this so that you can see what to focus on. So here we have math, it's on high numbers from 7 to 11 compared to, let's say, statistics, it's only 4 to 6. Like, I didn't take statistics in college, so I just reviewed quickly and I didn't spend too much time on it because I didn't want to waste my time on, like, you know, 4 to 6 questions. And honestly, I think I only got like 3 questions in my test for statics, and it was for statistics, and it was very straightforward questions. So then we have computational tools also on low level, ethics, engineering, econ, statics, we have high number, dynamics, low number, mechanics of materials, we have a high number, hydrology and hydraulics, it's at the high number as well from 8 to 12. I do remember getting a lot of questions on this material. So if you don't know it really well, make sure you review your notes and you focus on it. Structural analysis, structural design, I did get like about, I would say, these two, I would say I got about like 10 questions on it. So there were a lot of questions on structural analysis and structural design. Geotechnical engineering, definitely, it's actually the highest number from 9 to 14 questions. Transportation, I did get a lot of questions. Environmental, I honestly don't remember getting a lot of questions. I think I got only like 3 total. So I didn't take environmental in my school, so I just studied from the FE manual, which kind of helped, and I think I was able to answer most of them, but it was a lot of it was just conceptual questions. So it was, some of it was just like common sense. And surveying, I remember getting like 2 questions, one on leveling and one on like, I think it was like an area computation. So as you can see, a lot of these materials you already probably covered on your classes. And so it also gives you a breakdown of how many questions you have there, so you can use all these strategies so that you can study for your test. So the way I just broke down this specification, you can use this method as well for whatever FE you're taking. As you guys noticed, I did highlight some of the subjects here, and this is just for the test that I took. I had a lot of these questions on these subjects, so I will, in the future, I will be posting videos on these questions and I will go over them, and then hopefully it can help you prepare better for the test. So on the NCEES website, we also have the manual, FE manual. And in this manual, what we have is all the equations that you will need during the exam. So you can download this book for free on their website, but I believe you have to sign up first. So just make sure you do that. I will leave this link in the description below. So once you can also purchase a copy, but I don't recommend it because you in the exam, you will have access to this manual electronically. So you want to get used to it. And so as you're studying, make sure you have the PDF file open and make sure you get familiar with it, know where the equations are, so you don't have to waste time during the test trying to look for the equations. This is the reference handbook that I downloaded at once I signed up on the NCEES website. So as you can see here, we have all the materials that will be on the test. However, just be careful. Some of these things might not apply to you. Like if you're taking FE Civil, you will not have questions on thermodynamics or heat transfer. So this is mostly for FE Mechanical or FE General. So if you want to learn more about what will be covered on your specific exam, make sure you go over the specifications that we talked about earlier. Also keep in mind that some of the equations are not here. I found that especially the case for transportation engineering. I will be covering those equations in future videos, so make sure you subscribe so you don't miss out. Okay, so let's do a recall. So remember, the first thing is the time. Manage your time properly. Make sure you spend only about 2 hours to 2 hours and 15 minutes on the first part so that you have more time on the second part because you will need it. Second, we talked about how to flag the questions. Make sure you go over the three cases and flag it so you don't want to get stuck and spend too much time on only one question when you could be solving so many other questions. The third thing we talked about was the break. Make sure you take a break. You don't have to take 25 minutes if you don't want to, but you have to take at least 10 to 15 minutes break. Then we talked about the specifications. Make sure you check the specification on the website before you actually start studying, so that way you know what to focus on. Know your weaknesses and just study those and just learn it and review and make sure you're ready for the test. And lastly, we talked about the handbook. Make sure get familiar with the handbook, know where the equations are so that you don't waste time during the exam trying to look for the right equation. I hope these tips will help you study better for your tests. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share it with your friends who might find it helpful. If you guys have any questions, please leave it in the comments below. Thank you guys for watching, and I will see you soon. À la prochaine! Oh yeah, everybody now.